In today's video, we are going to implement UI macro in dictionary attribute. So use case for this topic is that we will implement one icon in front of caller field, and when user click on that icon, then it will display the list of incident created for that caller. So let's understand this use case in ServiceNow application first. So let's move to ServiceNow application. So friend, this is my ServiceNow personal developer instance. So to understand the use case, let's type incident over here, click on create new. So what I'm going to implement today is that I'll place some icon in front of this caller field. Okay, so when user click on that particular icon, then what happened, whatever the name is given over here, for example, we have given the name like assignment first user, and after filling the name, when user click on that particular icon, then the list of all open incident or the list of all incident which is created for this particular user whose name is mentioned over here will get displayed in another pop-up window. Okay, so we will implement this functionality in UI macro. So let's move to a UI macro and we will create a new UI macro and implement this functionality. So friend, we have to type UI macro over here. Under system UI, we have option called UI macro. Click on UI macro. So here, please click on new button. So because we are creating a new UI macro over here. So friend, here we have to give a UI macro name. So please be remember that the UI macro name should be in small letters and there should be no space in between them. So we can give the name over here. We are giving a list name. Okay. So caller incident underscore list. So here we have to do a scripting. See, this is actually Jelly tags are using over here. So we will be covering a Jelly scripting in my upcoming next video. So let's start scripting. So we have to place an icon. So let's create some image over there. Icon can be, I am using a book icon. We can find icon in db underscore image table. Let's see where. See, we have lots of image under this table. Okay, so we can use any of the image from here what we want from this name, or we can also upload our image and we can use it as an icon. Okay, so here I am using the image that is book icon png. Image size is little big, so I am using 25%. Then height is also 25%. Okay. Then on the click of image, I need to execute some function. So let's say the function name could be incident, right? Incident list. Then we have to give some title. When user hover the mouse on that particular icon, I can say. Incident created for user for caller, right? And here we have to close image tag. Okay, so in this is basically a image I have used for the icon. So now I have to do a scripting for this on click function, right? So I am writing a script over here under script tags. Mentioned script language that can be JavaScript. So let's close the script tag first. I always close the script tag first Okay. So let's write the code over here. So, okay. So what do we have to do? We have to fetch the value from the caller field first. So let's write d underscore form dot get value. So in this way, I am getting a ID of a caller. Then let's say some table name that I am giving incident neighborhood incident, because we are implementing this for incident. Okay. Let's say so we have to create a URL, so that on click we should navigate to some URL. Table name plus underscore list, because we have to open the list. Okay. And then okay, plus okay, now where window to open the pop-up. Let's say that top window. Okay, now I am calling through this variable pop-up options. Oh no, pop-up open focus. And then we have to pass some parameters in it. The parameters is URL, and then another can be like sys underscore ref underscore list. You can also learn it, or you can copy or paste it from somewhere. This is basically a window size which I am going to give, and so here okay, we haven't mentioned the function name over here. Function is that was a big mistake actually. Okay, so here I think we are done with the coding, the scripting in Jellytech. So let's save the UI macro. So friend, let's understand the scripting part. So what we have did, we have created an image through a UI macro where we have calling an incident on click. Okay, this image basically we have got through db underscore image table. So here we have defined the function body where we have mentioned that we are getting access ID of a caller which we are going to fill in incident. Then the table name, then we are creating a URL query, and then we are popping up the window. So let's see friend how we can implement this UI macro, or how we can use or call this UI macro in dictionary attribute. So let's navigate to incident form. So see friend, this is incident form where we have to call a UI macro in caller dictionary attribute. So right click on caller, click on configure dictionary. So basically caller is basically a reference field. So we have an option called attribute over here, and we also have an option in attribute over here. So give ref underscore contribution is equals to our UI macro name is caller incident list. So in this way we can call a UI macro in dictionary attribute. Or if we are not giving the name over here, we can also click on new. Okay, I'll save it, then I'll explain. So when I save it, see the name will auto get displayed over there as well. In attribute series. Okay, so either we can declare here, or we can create a new attribute from here. Okay, so let's navigate to the incident form to see that whatever UI macro we have created is got implemented or not. So move to ServiceNow, type incident. Here I'm typing create new. See, the icon got implemented over here under caller field. So friends, what I'm going to do, I'm selecting a caller from here like system administrator. Then I'm going to click on this book icon. See, the message is getting displayed, show callers open incident. So I think you remember that the message we have given in the image tag, gs.getMessage, right? So that message is getting displayed when we hover the mouse over here. So when we click on this, see the incident which is created for this caller, system administrator, the list of those incidents are getting displayed over here. So if we change the user to some other user, for example, we are selecting Brett Luby and we click on this, see the incident which is created for Brett Luby are getting displayed over here. So friend, in this way, we can call a UI macro through dictionary attribute of a particular reference field. So friend, this is all for this video. I will be posting more videos on UI macros for other scenarios as well, such as calling UI macro in another UI macro or using UI macro in UI page. So friend, if you like this video, please share my channel and please also subscribe my channel. Thank you friends. Bye bye. Have a nice day.